It's time for Live in Tallahassee, the region's number one source for entertainment news. Live in Tallahassee is brought to you by these local businesses: Sonny's Barbecue, Kraft Nissan, your iHeart radio stations, Silver Digital Media. And now, here's tonight's host, Joel Silver.
You are looking at the Red Hills Horse Trials up in north side of Tallahassee. The site of some exciting horse activities this past weekend, and also the site of this week's episode of Live in Tallahassee. And wow, what a show we have for you today. Standing next to me, with us throughout the show today, Spencer Sturmey. And we are thrilled to have him here. Now, Spencer is an international rider, but Spencer, you're also an international commentator. You're on television, especially over in the UK. And we are thrilled to have you in Tallahassee.
Well, it's an absolute pleasure to be here. I was here last year, and I was very lucky to be invited back this year. It's an incredible venue, and what a job they do.
So let's talk about this. In terms of Red Hills, this is a qualifying event. This is the qualifiers for the Olympics, but also, I mean, some of the biggest riders in the world are here, is that right?
We've got world number 7, number 10 here. So many people from the riders from the FEI World Ranking are here in Tallahassee. And as you say, quite rightly, it's a really important year and a stepping stone for those that are aiming towards those Rio Olympics in a few months' time. It's creeping closer and closer all the time.
Unreal. And see, it's right here in our home city. This is unbelievable. Now, it's so big, we're going to dedicate most of the show to Red Hills. For the next 30 minutes, we'll show you all the stuff that happens here. And Spencer, if you have a second to tell us, let's go through it, because there's three different stages that people will have to know about, right?
So there are three stages. It's equivalent as an equine triathlon. So they start with the dressage, which is on day one. The dressage is basically their judge. They have two judges that judge the dressage, and that is just to judge the harmony, the balance, the rhythm, the way the horses go, how they communicate, connect with the riders. They do it in an arena. So the arena is 20 meters by 60 meters. It's not a very big arena. In walk, trot, and canter. So the three basic gaits of a horse. They then move on to the stadium jumping, which is a set of show jumps that we had 12 show jumps, 12 to 14 show jumps with combinations of doubles and trebles, related distances, which in horse terms means one stride, yes, two strides, three strides. Maximum height for the three star is 1.25 meters, so quite big fences in there to show the agility, the athleticism, and all-round horsemanship really in the show jumping. And then on to the really important part and the really exciting part for everybody, the cross country. And it's full of thrills, spills. It's a really big adrenaline rush with all of the riders, and that then we get the winner at the end of that. So penalized in the dressage, marks 1 to 10 awarded. Lowest mark is the winner. Well, not the winner, but the best score. Show jumping, penalties are given for a fence down. And then the cross country, that's an optimum time. They can get penalties for being over the optimum time. If they have a stop at a fence, it's 20 penalties. And that's all added, and it's so exciting.
I mean, it is. It's so exciting, and it happens every year here, and we're thrilled that it's grown to this level. And I'm glad you're here, because I couldn't have said any of that. So it's great that Spencer's going to be with us. So let's start right now. Let's take a look at the first stage. Here is dressage.
I'm joined today by the president of the Grand Jury for the CIC Three Star from Great Britain, Sandy Phillips. Sandy, welcome.
Thank you very much.
So the dressage phase, what are you looking for in the horse and rider combinations? We've got 41 coming forward for the dressage.
Well, obviously we're looking for the horse-rider combination on the day that can present us with the horse that is the most balanced, that can then show us how well he can move within that balance and not lose it, so they start to run, make mistakes, and show the inconsistencies that we often see in these tests. So it's always very important to get one perspective from C on the center line and another perspective from the side, because it is a very different picture from both those angles.
And I think that's what a lot of people don't understand, and what a lot of riders don't understand as well when they get their dressage sheets back, because you judge and it's marked out of 10, 10 being perfect. We do see the odd 10 coming, of course, but 1, 0 for not performed, and that the scale of judging. And now you've got your half marks as well. You can award a 0.5.
Yes, that's actually been a great blessing, because sometimes it's quite harsh. The most used marks are 6 and 7. So now that you have 6.5, you can, if a horse is trying to do the right thing, you can reward them by giving them the half mark, which I think is a great addition.
Well, Sandy, thank you very much. Good luck with the dressage, and we'll see you again, I'm sure, later on in the show.
Thank you very much.
Been slow smoking over oak for more than 45 years. And while sticking to tried and true traditions is kind of our thing, it doesn't hurt to throw something new in the smoker every now and then. Come get some slow smoked chicken wings at Sonny's Barbecue. Order them as an appetizer or as part of a combo with pork, baby back ribs, or both, starting at $10.99. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmaster since 68.
Every morning, the sun rises on our fair city. A while later, Chris, the late riser, wakens for a day of work and involvement in FSU and community, serving Tallahassee as he has for years. Across town, Brother Peter, the early riser, has already turned on the lights, checked itineraries, and game-planned with loyal employees who've been showing up every day for decades. And as the day rolls into business mode, the brothers orchestrate what has come to be recognized as Tallahassee's premier auto dealership. Your car dealer, Kraft Nissan.
Red Hills Horse Trial. And tell everybody your name.
I'm Victoria Garland.
And she's in the one-star category. And tell me what that means exactly.
The one-star is about a level above the preliminary level, which is the international class for that level. So you are going from just the national class to competing under the FEI instead of just the USCF and USCA level. And so it's a harder dressage test, a little bit of a harder cross-country, and a little bit of a higher show jumping.
Gotcha. Is this your first time?
Yes, this is my first international class.
And have you already jumped?
No, I show jump. I'm currently sitting. Sorry. I'm currently sitting 19th in the show jumping, so we're in reverse order of go. So I go in about an hour.
Well, good luck to you. Seems like your horse is ready already.
Oh, he's ready to roll.
And tell us a little bit about what you just competed in.
I'm in the CIC One Star, which is sort of the younger up-and-coming horses. And this fella here is high aspirations, and I've got high aspirations for this horse, and he jumped very, very well, so I'm pleased with him.
Well, the horse that I'm sitting on at the moment, his name's Effie Subiaco. He's a horse that we've brought over from Germany, and one that I'm just producing and getting ready to sell. He's a very friendly chap, as you can see. Yeah. This is his first FEI class, first CIC one star. So yeah, he went super in the dressage and the cross country, and hopefully in a little while I can jump a nice clear and finished his day off in a nice fashion.
So now tell me, is this your first time at Red Hills?
Yeah, it is.
He says yes.
Here and you're on the city commission, correct?
Yes, I am. Yeah.
Now tell me about your experience with this event.
Well, I've been here before when it was in another part of the course, and I haven't been here since they moved it. So I'm extremely impressed at all the improvements they've made, especially the safety improvements with the footing for the horses. This granite dirt that they've put out here is fascinating to me. They have really got this down to a science, and I'm sure every year they learn more about it, but the thought and the care that goes into making sure people have absolutely everything that they need so that all they have to do is think about performing, I was very pleased. And they've been kind enough to thank the Parks and Rec Department and the city every time I'm anywhere, so I'm really proud of the job here, and also proud of the folks from Red Hills that put this on, because there's 17 countries represented. I mean, this is an international event. This is a major, people internationally are hearing about this event. So very proud all the folks that have made this possible.
Now I have the Honorable Judge Nina and her wonderful husband, Curtis Richardson, with me. Now you guys have been involved in this event for quite a few years.
Yes. And we have always enjoyed it, Allie. We've come every year. This year our kids had an opportunity to come to witness this tremendous event. This is an event that has really put Tallahassee on the world map. And now, as a city commissioner, I can lay claim to the fact that the city is one of the biggest sponsors of this event. And I've heard, ever since I've been here this morning, the gratitude on the part of the organizers for the volunteer work that our city staff has done to make this happen.
I think a lot of people don't realize that this is an international event that leads to Olympic aspirations. So I think that's important to note. And how's your experience been, Judge Nina?
Allie, thank you so much. I have had so much fun, and this is so tremendous for Tallahassee that we have an opportunity to see the equestrian community at all levels and some of the most amazing horses. And so thank you for promoting this event, and I'm here as a spectator just to enjoy every moment of it.
Great. Thank you guys so much.
All right, Allie, thank you.
Wheezy's Home and Cottage. There's so much here for your home, you may never want to leave. Home and Cottage in the Market District next to Narcissus. Hey, where did Ann and Audra go?
Okay, back now with Spencer Sturmey live in Tallahassee resumes, and we are having a great time here at the Red Hills Horse Trials 2016. Spencer, we've been through two events now. You went through them early on in the show. So we've been through the dressage, we've been through the stadium jumping, but now we're about to see cross country. And you said earlier, this is the exciting stuff.
Well, it really is. And the spectators are gathering around the more difficult complexes out on the course. We've got a new water complex. Mike Etherington Smith from the UK is the course designer here. It's his first time here, actually. And that's quite unusual because he does a lot in America. But first time at Red Hills International. Red Hills now been running for 18 years. Can you believe it?
I cannot. So, and we've been doing some lead up to this event. And the jumps and everything out here, in addition to being enormous, they're also kind of fun, and some of them have a local flavor. Does that happen around the world?
It really does. I mean, if you go back to, especially at Olympics, you know, they have the trademark buildings that are used, but all around the world they have their own take on the cross-country fences. And it's a real opportunity for the course designers to put their own stamp on a cross-country course. Quite difficult, I think, as well, for somebody to come in that's new. It doesn't just happen. These fences don't just pop out of the ground.
Right. We learned that.
He's here for months and months and months of planning and preparation, a lot of ground preparation, and the city of Tallahassee that do so much for this event, especially with the watering and the ground preparation. Fantastic.
I love it. Well, I love to hear that we're known around the world and people love what we do here. So that's great. All right. I want to thank Spencer for being with us throughout the show. Let's take a look at some of the fun and excitement of cross country.
Mustangs. We're at Red Hills and we're here to promote adoption of Mustangs. This is my horse Zola. I've had her for almost 20 or 10 years. So we're out here just enjoying the day at Red Hills and enjoying this beautiful day.
I'm president of Tallahassee Big Dog Rescue. We're a nonprofit rescue organization that just turned 18 years. So we've been saving dogs in our community for the last 18 years. We're out at Red Hills Horse Trial. We've been here every year since they've started, just out meeting the crowd, hopefully trying to get a few dogs adopted, but mainly promoting the importance of adopting instead of shopping, because there's so many rescue dogs that have absolutely wonderful personalities and temperaments. So we hope that the community will learn that there's a lot of rescue groups in our area and it's better to adopt an animal than to purchase one.
Hi, I'm Kimberly Von Stardy and I am from the Red Hills Polo Club. And we are just right down the road from the Red Hills Horse Trials. And it's on the same property as the Horse Trials. And we're here trying to promote our club and get people to know that we have a polo club down the road. And we actively play every Saturday at 11 till 2 o'clock. It's on Cedar Hill Road and we have our demonstrating guy here who is his birthday today. It's Dickie Von Stardy. Dickie, you're going to show us a swing here? Oh, there we go. He's showing us a half swing. And here are our girls over here. These are our students. And look at this beautiful artwork by Denise. It is wonderful. Denise, how do you pronounce your surname? Boy, no, it's one of those funny French names. But here she is. This is her beautiful art. And she's gladly come out and showed her art, which is up for sale today if anyone wanted to buy it. But we have a lot of ponies at the Polo Club, and we have beginner lessons, advanced lessons, horses for sale, horses for lease, pasture for board. We got it all at the Red Hills Polo Club. So come on over and see our stall, get some shirts, get on the wooden horse and take some shots. We are loving the horse trials. I have to pull myself away from the jumps to come back here, but we just love it. Everybody's in a good mood and the weather's great, and we just love the Red Hills horse trials.
All right, so you're looking around at some footage here at Red Hills. Lots of stuff going on in addition to the horse competition. Check this out, there's pet adoptions. There's great food being served all over. And there's pony rides. Check out everybody out there on the pony rides having a good time. But where people are having a really good time, and now joined by Rose Knapp, and you know about this, Rose, is the tailgates. The tailgates are the big hit of the 2016 Red Hills Horse Trials.
Yes, new this year, tailgating. Right on the edge of the new water complex, we have three tailgate options. Tents on the water, tents on the lane, we've got parking on the tree line. We almost sold out this year. It's been very popular. We did a tailgate contest. We had first, second, and third place winners. The sweet tea party won first place. Oh yeah, they had beautifully decorated tent. The ladies were wonderful. China settings, lots of little kids in little matching dresses. It's absolutely beautiful.
It really is a great way to watch Red Hills then, but in general, all over all these acres. It's been a great day. Rose, you and I have been talking for months. We've had you on the show several times. So it's turned out just great.
And don't forget, Sunday is hat day.
Yes.
I'm warming up my hat.
So talk about the course. Is everybody happy with what they've seen?
Well, actually, I was talking to the U.S. Olympic coach earlier, and I also happened to talk to the Olympic coach for the team from Mexico, and they're here trying to qualify riders, and both of them said the improvements this year, the footing, the new course design, the arena footing, they said all of it is great. It said every year Red Hills gets a little bit better, and this year we made great strides in the footing. The riders are really pleased, and you know, you got to please the riders, or you know, they'll go somewhere else.
We want them to keep coming back year after year.
Absolutely. And we have riders from all over.
I love it.
Don't go away. We'll be back with more of Live in Tallahassee right after this brief commercial break. Thanks for tuning in to Live in Tallahassee this evening. Make sure to follow us on Facebook and join us next Thursday night, 10:30 p.m. right here on Fox 49. On behalf of Silver Digital Media, this is your announcer, John Summer, speaking. Good night, everybody.